Hello viewers, in this module we are going to discuss that is first question. It is given that L is parallel to M. To prove that angle 1 is supplementary to angle 8, write reasons for the statement. So here they are given that angle 1 is supplementary to angle 8. So this angle and these are our exterior angles. So here interior angles, what are the inside of these two lines? That is interior angles. What are the exterior angles means? This is exterior outside to the line. This is also exterior. So if two corresponding exterior angles on the same side of the transversal, then that is supplementary, then two lines will be parallel. So here this is transversal line. Transversal line. So which are intersecting both the lines. So it's making equal angles. For that, you can take it as corresponding angles axial. So you can take it as corresponding angles axial. So let's write corresponding angles axioms. Next one, our angle 1 will be equal to angle 5. So what is that here is angle 1 will be equal to angle 5. Angle 1 and angle 5. So this is corresponding angles on the same side of transversal. So angle 1 here, corresponding angles are equal, alternate interior angles are equal, interior angles are sum will be equal to 180 degrees, like that, so many conditions. So angle 1 and angle 5 are corresponding angles. Corresponding angles on the same side of transversal. Corresponding angles. So that is corresponding is nothing but the angle 1 and angle 5, these and these will be corresponding. On the same side angles, this one will be corresponding. So here this point is located angle 5 here. Then this one, this angle, corresponding angles. So that is the thing. Next, angle 5 plus angle 8 will be equal to 180 degrees. So here angle 5 and angle 8. So this making linear pair angles. So angle 5 and angle 8. So where is that? Here. Angle 5 and angle 8. This angle is making linear pair angles. Linear pair angles. That is the condition. Linear pair angles. So why? Because angle 5 and angle 8 are adjacent angles. The two are adjacent angles. Then angle 1 and angle 8 will be equal to 180 degrees. So here angle 1, so let's take this angle, and angle 8 will be equal to 180 degrees. Why? Because here angle 1 will be equal to angle, so angle 1 will be equal to angle 5. Then angle 5 plus angle 8 is 180 degrees. In the place of that angle 1, you can write it that one. So what is this exterior corresponding? So what you can take, they are getting supplementary angles. So these two angles, sum of these two angles making is 180 degrees. For that it is, so angle 1 and angle 8 are forming supplementary angles and both are consecutive angles. So angle 1 and angle 8 are making supplementary angles. Supplementary angles, and both are consecutive angles. Consecutive exterior angles. So these are the outside angles. That one. Next, what you can take it here is angle 1 is supplementary to angle 8. Yes, that is supplementary angles. These two are making exterior angles. Angle 1 and angle 8 are exterior angles and they are consecutive to each other. Yes, angle 1 is supplementary to angle 8. So what you can take it here is, let's take angle 1 and angle 8 are supplementary to each other. So angle 1 plus angle 8 will be equal to 180 degrees. Then what you can say? So they are co-exterior angles. They are exterior co-exterior angles. So a co-exterior angles means same side of transversal, what you can say, same side of transversal, their exterior angles. Like this we need to solve. Thanks for watching, please subscribe. So in the second question we are going to discuss that the adjacent figure AB as parallel to CD and CD parallel to EF and Y is to Z, that is, they are given that AB parallel to CD and CD is parallel to EF, then you can say AB is parallel to EF and Y is to Z, they are given the ratio 3:7, then we have to find the X value. So let's take YZ. So here what you can say here is alternate interior angles or equal. So this angle, so inside it is there, here also inside it is there. So this is the transversal. So let's take transversal LM. This line is transversal. Alternate interior angles are equal. So alternate means this should be come opposite sides of this transversal. So this is transversal. So, alternate interior angles equal, then what you can say, X will be equal to Z. So, here alternate interior angles equal to X is equals to Z. Then, next one, what you can do here is, they are given the Y and Z angles. So, let's take let y will be equal to 3x degrees and z will be equal to 7x degrees. Why? Because 3:7. Then here y, z are there. So this x is equals, now x is equals to what you can take? Then x is equals to z, that will be equal to 7x degrees. So what you can say here is, you can go with two methods. So here y is there, here also y you will get. Why? Because these are our corresponding angles. So these corresponding angles are equal. Then from linear pair y plus x will be equal to 180 degrees. So y is equals to what here? 3x. Then x is equals to what here? 7x. That will be equal to 180 degrees. So 10x will be equal to 10x degrees will be equal to 180. Then x will be equal to 180 by 10. So 10 ones are 10 18s are, then x will be equal to 18 degrees. By this you can x we got. Another method is there. We can go with here corresponding interior angles, sum of corresponding interior angles. You can go with like this also, sum of interior angles on the same side of transversal, that will be equal to x plus y will be equal to, so x plus y will be equal to 180 degrees. Transversal is 180 degrees. Actually here sum of the interior angles on the same side of transversal will be is equal to 180 degrees. So here also we can get like that, that is 3x plus 7x, that will be equal to 180 degrees, then 10x will be equal to 180 degrees, then x will be equal to 180 by 10, that will be equal to 18 degrees. Then what are the x values and y values? So you can find x and y like that. So x will be equal to, that will be equal to here, you can take it as x will be equal to z. So x will be equal to z, or simply you can take it as here AA also like that, 7. So x will be equal to z, here we can take it as x here. So we are here x degrees is a variable, here x is an angle. So you can take it as angle x. So here also angle x, angle y. Here also, so here angle x, angle z, angle y. Here also we can take it like this. So here x degrees will be equal to 18 degrees. Then 7 into 18. So what is that? 7 into 18 is nothing but, so what is that angle is? 126 degrees. Then y will be equal to 3x degrees, angle y, that is 3 into 18, 54 degrees. then z also 126 degrees. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe.